Hi all, today I am introducing another pro version of TDS calculation utility. This is for the professionals. The professionals have a lot of clients. So this utility developed for the professionals. This is the pro version. Just to go through the functionalities. From this utility, you can easily fill up the RPU. So who are not using any TDS software, they can simply use this utility for calculating TDS, for remitting TDS, for filing quarterly returns by using any TDS software or by using NSDL RPU. So how can we fill the RPU? Just go through it. This is the RPU which is downloaded from tinnsdl.com. Here we have to select the form name. I am selecting 26Q regular. Click on open a regular file. File opened successfully. Now the form is filled automatically. 18 challans is here. These 18 challans we filled within 2 or 3 minutes. And the deductee details, we have 41 deductees. These 41 deductees we filled within 2 or 3 minutes. So here for 15G or 15H also applied. The deductee company or non-company. Everything is filled automatically within a short time. After completing this form, challan and annexure deductee details, create file. Here select the CSI file. Here select the error upload report file path. So the same folder we can select for error file. Now the CSI file be attached and the error report file path also given. Click on validate. File validated successfully at path so and so. Please submit FUV in pen drive and duly signed physical form 27A. Click on OK. OK. Now see the form 27A created. The FUV file also created. So within a fraction of a second, we have completed the RPU with 18 challans and 41 deductees. So this utility is very useful for the professionals and also who are not using any TDS software. I am Sabu Joseph. Welcome to SVJ Academy. Hundreds of practical and useful videos relating to income tax, TDS, EPF, ESI, Microsoft Excel, and other accounting classes are available in my channel. Kindly watch it and drop your comments. A Facebook group is also available. Kindly join the group. Today, we are going to see a very useful, interesting utility. This is very much useful for the professionals who have lot of clients. The professionals can save lot of time by calculating, preparing challans, uploading challans. First, I will introduce the areas of this utility. Utility is very simple. This is the report area. On the report area, first of all, you can see the name of the companies. So if you have hundreds of clients, all the clients' name will be shown here. So I have given a database for the company details. Here you can enter the name of each client, their PAN number and TAN number here. And also here you can write the contact person, contact mobile number and all the details relating to the clients also. So here you can add any client that will appear here. So this is the client list. This is the PAN number of the client. This is form 24Q or 26Q. The financial year, quarters, months, when we deducted TDS, under which section we deducted TDS, that will appear here. The deductee status, whether they are company or non-company, whether they have given 15H or 15G declaration, the status of the TDS amount, whether it is remitted to government or not remitted to government, the name of the deductees, the PAN number of the deductees, if the client have multiple branches all over India, the details of branches, all these data we will get from this report. For that, nothing required, just select the company. Now the company 2 selected, the data related to company 2 loaded here. Select the form you want, whether 24Q or 26Q and the financial year. Now I am selecting 2021 financial year. And we have to file TDS return for the fourth quarter of financial year 2021. So selecting fourth quarter, the fourth quarter month, January, February, March loaded. We can see each month. Click on January, January loaded. Click on February, February loaded. click on March loaded. But we want the 3 months. And again, the section under which we deducted TDS shown here. Who are the parties under section 194A? Who are the parties 194H? And who are the parties 194JB? And also, who are the company deductees? Who are the non-company deductees? This company deductee and non-company deductee we have to use while remitting the TDS amount to the government. And also, we are remitting the TDS to the government by section wise only. Here we have three sections, that is the data given. So we have to remit the TDS under section 194A. So select 194A, three parties available. These three parties are non-company. So for 4,20,081 rupee, all these parties given form 15G and form 15H. See here, the status is showing. These two parties given 15H and this party given 15G. So the TDS amount showing nil. Go to another section. So here we no need to pay anything to government. Go to 194H section. Here we have non-company deductees. 2,969 rupees we deducted TDS under section 194H. 2 months are shown here. So we have to remit the TDS for the month of March. So whatever the month you want to remit the TDS, just select the month. If you want to remit the month of February, select February. 1,515 rupees we have to pay. If it is March, select the March. If it is April, it will load here. When it is 2021, it will come here. See, select the financial 2021. Only Q1 is shown here. April and May. This company have April and May challan. This company 3 have only April challan. This company 4 have April, May and June under three sections, company and non-company. So we can remit the amount by selecting the concerned month. If I am selecting June month, this June month TDS we have to remit on or before 7th of July 2021. So click on June. 3524 we have to pay under section 194A. Again under section 194C there is nothing for the month of June. 194JB, nothing. So we can simply select each month, each section. We will get the grand total of that concerned section. We can very easily make the payment. And also, when we file the quarterly returns, at that time, we want the how much amount we paid, the date on which paid or credited, under which section we deducted TDS, the rate of TDS, how much is the TDS amount. So all these details we will get. If we want to file Q1 return, select Q1, the company 4, the data of company 4 for the quarter 1 2021, all these challans relating to 26Q only. So when we fill the form by using the TDS software or using the RPU, we have enough data to fill everything. This is the report area. Now we can see how we will input the data to this utility. So I have given a database for the utility. In this database, we can calculate the TDS with its concerned section automatically. No need to remember the TDS rates, threshold limits. The utility will automatically calculate. So here, the first we have to select the client name. When we selected the client name, the PAN and the TAN will automatically load. Here select whether the form relating to 24Q, 26Q, 27Q or 27EQ. Here I am selecting 26Q, which quarter this challan relates to. Here all the four quarters given, I am selecting Q1. Select the financial year 21-22. The date of the bill or payment, 29 June 2021. If we have invoice, enter the invoice number here, otherwise keep it blank. Here enter the bill amount, suppose 25,000. If the bill have GST amount, enter the GST amount here, because we want to calculate the TDS on bill amount except GST. Suppose in this case 5,000 is the GST. So the rest of the amount is 20,000. On 20,000 only we have to calculate TDS. The status of the deductee, whether they are company or non-company. Here I am selecting company. Whether PAN available or not. If the PAN is not available, the TDS rate will be 20%. If available, select yes. Then the PAN number of the deductee. the section with nature of payments. This is a drop-down list. Under this drop-down list, you can see all the sections with its name. So here I am selecting section 194A, interest other than interest on securities. When I select the section, the concerned section will load here. Its threshold limit will load here. Now 194A automatically selected. 5000 is the threshold limit. Whether 15G or 15H applicable. If 15G or H is applicable, select that one. If it is not applicable, select NA. If we select 15G or 15H, the TDS rate will be 0. The TDS amount will be 0. If select not applicable, see the rate of TDS under section 194A 10%. The income subject to TDS here 20,000. So the 10% of 20,000 automatically calculated. Here give the deductee name. Here it is showing the balance amount to be payable to the deductee. 25,000 is the bill amount. Out of that 25,000, we have deducted 2,000 TDS. So 23,000 we have to pay to the deductee. Here we can select the branch name if the deductee have multiple branches. Here the status is whether it is remitted to government or not remitted to government. We ended this challenge on 29th June, so it is not remitted to government, so select not remitted. After remitting the challenge, we have to select the name of the bank through which we made the payment, the BSR code, date of remittance, challenge number, and two more columns we have to fill. Whether TDS deposit by book entry, here no. The minor head of challenge, 200 or 400, 200. Now we completed the data input. Only few fields we have to enter. So we can easily calculate the TDS amount from here. Suppose if we want to change this section, it will load like that. See 194 dividends, it's also showing 10%. If it is 194C, payment to contractor or subcontractor, see 194C loaded here. Threshold limit 30,000 in a single bill or 75,000 in a year, 2% selected. Now the TDS calculated 20,000 into 2% for 400 rupees. If it is an HUF or individual, the rate will be 1%. So one more section given here, 194C, payment to contractors, subcontractors, HUF, individuals. Now that section selected, the rate is 1%. Now the TDS is 200. Either the professional or the deductor can easily calculate the TDS by using this utility. After completing the challenge, we are going to the crucial part, generating RPU. The video may be little bit lengthy. Don't skip the video. Each and every point is very valuable and it is very much useful for you. Now we completed one data entry here. Come to report. We selected the company 2. Now come to company 2. Financial year 21-22. Now we can see only 3 deductees. Just right click and refresh. The newly added deductee came here. Now the total TDS amount 4174. So you can use this utility for hundreds of clients. No need to worry about anything at the time of filing the quarterly returns or at the time of making the payment to the government. You can simply share this utility to your clients. Each client will fill the data when they make the payments, so they can easily calculate the TDS without any error. And also we got it filled at the month end or at the end of the quarter. You can just simply call the file. So all the data which is filled by the deductor company, you can just copy the concerned data to your master copy because all the fields are same. No need to re-enter. Now your master data will be updated. This master data will be shuffled with the companies. No issue. Don't need to keep each company in a serial wise. Here you can see company 3, another company, company 6, company 3, company 4, company 5, company 3, 2. See, the companies are shuffled, but in our reports, we can get each company data separately. So you can simply give the utility to your client. Now we've seen how we will enter the data to the database. After completing all the data relating to the concerned quarter, you can prepare the RPU from here. If you are using any TDS software, you can simply enter the data with the available details. No need to call the ledgers, details, challenges. The client itself recorded all the details in the database. If you are using the TDS software, first of all, we have to enter the challan to the software. After entering the challan to the software, we have to bifurcate that challan amount to the deductives. So when we bifurcate the amount to different deductives, the date of payments, the total amount of payments, everything you have to mention. So that everything we will get from here. This is the total amount without GST we have to mention on the software. And when it is paid on 31st May 2021. So the payment date here, the amount here, the TDS amount also here. The section is here, the rate is here. If it is April, you can see 92B, 194JB, 194H, and here also 194JB. So when we apportion this 94JB challan, just select 94JB. Under this challan, two deductives are available. Select the PAN number of the deductive from the TDS software. After selecting the PAN number or name, we have to mention the date of payment. The date of payment here, 20th April 2021. The amount is without GST 5000. Then we have to select the consent section. So when we selected the consent section, 194JB or whatever it is, the software itself will calculate the TDS amount. So the TDS amount provided by the software and our calculation will be same. So in this way, you can easily fill the data to the TDS software. This is the case if you are using the TDS software. If you are using the RPU, which is provided by the NSDL, for filling the RPU form, we need so many hours. So in this utility, I have given the same format of RPU. For downloading the RPU, go to tinnsdl.com. This is the portal of tinnsdl. And under services, eTDS and TCS, here we can see file validation utility, eTDS TCS RPU. Open the eTDS or eTCS RPU. Here you can see the latest RPU version. The latest RPU version is version 3.6. Download it. Now it is downloaded. Now the RPU downloaded. Open the folder. Here you can see so many Java files. Here you can see TDS RPU 3.6. Open it. Here, first of all, we have to select the form name, whether 24Q or 26Q. Select 26Q. Click on continue. So first of all, we have to fill the form. This form relating to the deductor. The deductor PAN number, TAN, address, responsible person, all these data we have to fill. This form we can fill one time and we can save the file. That saved file we can load here. Just see, I will load the form which is already created. No need to type each time. Now the form is auto-filled. So this file you can just like save, you can keep it for the future purpose. Every time the company details will be same except some areas. Here at the end it is asking, has regular statement for form 26Q filed for earlier period. If we select yes, we have to give the acknowledgement number of the TDS return filed for the last quarter. This is the only change we have to do in the form. Rest of the areas are same. The company name never changed, TAN never changed, PAN never changed. If the person responsible for deducting tax, that only we have to update when it is changed. It will not change every month. So as and when it is changed, we have to update it. That is also one day. So this is a small work. We can save it. The challan and annexer details is a very big work. So this challan have 23 fields. So how many challans we have? We have to insert that much rows. Each area we have to fill. There is a chance for mistake when we input data to the RPU. Or if you appointed a new accountant, that accountant may not be well aware of this RPU because so many things it is asking here, he can't do because so many data we require to fill here. To avoid these problems, on the utility itself, I given the RPU challenge details. So this is the RPU challenge details, which is auto fetched from the database. Here we can see all the company names shown here. All company PAN, company TAN, financial year, firm name, quarter, month, the section under which we deducted TDS, the challenge number also shown here. So this is the same template which is given by the NSDL. Select one of your clients. Now the data relates to that client loaded. Select the financial year. I am selecting 2021. Here select the firm name, whether it is 24Q or 26Q. I am selecting 26Q and I am selecting quarter four of 2020-21. January, February and March. So 41 deductees we have for the fourth quarter. So all these 41 deductee details we have to enter to RPU. So first of all, we have to fill up the challenge details. So for the 41 deductees, how much challenge available? Here you can see this much challenge available. So each challenge we have to enter separately. So select one challenge. This challenge have only one deductee. So go to RPU, click on add rows, enter number of rows to be added. Give one. Now one row added. So here on the white field, we have to enter the data. Here no need to enter the data manually. You can select the total of the challenge from here. Here only one deductee, so only showing one. Just copy the total of challenge amount from here. Click here and use Control V, paste special. Now the data filled with all these fields. Now come to next. Here we have to enter the BSR code. Our utility itself showing the BSR code. Paste here. The date of tax deposited. Paste here. So on the RPU, it is given the column numbers 1 to 23. In our utility itself, I have given the same column number for easy identification. 1 to 23 you can see here. So here we have to enter the data from column number 18 to 22. So go to column number 18 to 22, copy the entire data, select the cell number 18, colon, cell the cell, Control V. Now the data copied to the RPU. Now we added one challenge. After adding the challenge, we have to apportion this amount to the deductees. So go to Annexure Deductees. Here we have only one deductee. On the RPU, we can see three tabs: Form, Challenge and Annexure Deductee Details. But on our utility, I have given only one tab. The first will be the challenge details. Already I highlighted on the title challenge details. After challenge details, it is showing the deductee details. So on the deductee details, we can see the column numbers 1 to 33. So 1 to 33 columns provided for the deductee and extra details. The same number I given here, 1 to 33. So there is no confusion on the columns. And also on under the deductee details of our utility, you can see the count of the deductees. Only one is showing here. So go to an extra deductee details. Click on insert row. When we click on insert row, it is showing the challenge numbers we created. Only one challenge we created now. We have to assign the deductees to that challenge. So enter one, click on OK. Now one row inserted. Come to our utility. All these yellow shaded area given to the deductees. So on the RPU, the first one is section under which payment made. That is on the sixth column. This is the sixth column of our utility. It is showing 194A. So select 194A. The next is serial number, deductee reference number. There is no need of this one. Column number 14 to column number 20 we have to fill. Column number 14, PAN of the deductee. 15, name of the deductee. Date of payments or credit. Amount paid or credit. TDS amount, surcharge, education cess. So go to our utility. Here 14 to 20. Select the data. Control V. Paste special. Data copied. Tax deposited automatically fetched. Again from column number 25 to 28 we have to select the date of deduction, Remarks for non-deduction or lower deduction. Here we have to select the consent data, A for lower deduction, B in case of 15H or 15G, C deduction of tax under higher rate. So the consent applicable data we have to select here. So go to the utility, column number 25 to 28, select it, paste it. Here if you are deducting the TDS in normal cases, no need to select any remark. You can kept it blank, it will be shown as select. Here the deducting code 1 for company and 2 for other than company, automatically taken. Now we completed the first challan and assigned the deductives to the first challan. Again come back to the next challan. In this challan, we have two parties. Here this challan have seven parties. Here showing the number. So go to this part challan. So if it is in a bulk, if the data is very bulk, then only we have to spend lot of time. So here we selected one challan. That challan have seven deductives. Go to the challan, insert one more row. Here we have to give the challan detail. So this is the total amount of challan. So select the total, paste here. Again, we have to enter the BSR code and the date of payment. Both are showing here. The BSR code will be same. The date of payment will be same because it is a single challan. Paste here. The date, paste here. So here we have to enter the data from column number 18 to 22. So select the 18 to 22, paste here. See, now the data is fetched. This is the challan number 2. Now we entered the challan. Now go to annexure directory details, click on insert row. Here you can see one more challan number 2. This challan we have to bifurcate to the deductives. How many deductives we have? 7 deductives to this challan. So insert 7 rows to the challan number 2. Click on OK. Now 7 rows inserted. You can see the challan number here. All these challans are related to 2. Now here we have to mention the consent section we deducted TDS. This is under section 194A, so you can just copy and paste the data here. 194A completed, serial number and everything automatically taken, deductive reference number no need. Here we have to assign the deductive PAN, name, date of payment, amount paid, TDS deducted, everything. So column number 14 to 20, this is the column number 14 to 20, select the deductive details, 7 deductive details, paste here. See, within a fraction of a second we completed. Field 25 to 28, the date of deduction, remarks, deductive code, rate at which tax deducted, everything we have to fill. Come to 25 to 28, this is the 25 to 28, select it, paste here, completed. Now we completed the challan number 2. One more challan we have to enter. Under this challan, only one deductive we deducted TDS. The rest of the deductives have given form 15G. In our utility, it will be automatically considered from the database. When you hover the mouse on the cell, you can see the reference code. B means non-deduction under section 194A, 15G or 15H. So insert one more row on the RPU, go to challan, add rows 1. Here, take the total, paste here. Come here, enter the BSR code and the date of payment. So all these challans have same BSR code, the same date of payment. And here mention the challan number, only one challan we paid. So many comments I received on the YouTube. How we can enter the details regarding 15H or 15G declarations? We can assign the deductives only against the challan. So what we should do is select one challan and select the declarants also. Here only one challan, that challan is assigned to only one person. The rest of the 5 deductives given declaration. So along with this challan, I have selected the 15G or 15H declarants. Then only we can update the data. Otherwise, we can't add declarants only without the challan. So go to the RPU. We have to mention the mode of challan, the minor head. We have to select the minor head here, 200. This is the challan number 3. Go to annexure deductive. Here we want to insert 6 rows. So 6 deductives we have. These are the deductive details. So insert 6 rows to challan number 3. go to an extra directory details, insert row. We can see the cell number 3 here, insert 6 rows, enter 6, then OK. Now 6 rows ended here. This is also related to 94A. So select the just copy and paste 94A here. From column number 14 to 20, we have to fill the directory details. So column number 14 to 20, select it, paste it. Now we copied the data within a fraction of a second. See here, you can see the amounts paid or credited, but the TDS amount is zero. These are the 15G and 15H declarants. Come to here, 25 to 28, select the entire data, paste here. See, so when we paste it here, the remarks is showing B, non-deduction. If there is non-deduction, we can't show the date here. So everything will automatically shown in our utility. If it is remark here, it will not consider the date here. If there is no remark here, it will consider the date here. Now we completed everything. We can finish it within 3 or 4 minutes. Now RPU completed. Now click on create file. Now it is asking the Chelan input file name Bithupa. So before creating the file, one more thing we have to remember. We have to download the CSI file from the Altas. So in the RPU itself, on the last tab, we can see other services of TIN. Here we can see Chelan status inquiry. Click on that one. It will go to the Altas. Here TAN based view. Click on that one. Give the TAN number here. Then the Chelan tender date or date of deposit period. We are going to file the return for the fourth quarter of 2021, January 1st to 31st to March. So we have to select 1st January 2021 to 31st March 2021. 31st March 2021. Then the CAPTCHA code, enter the CAPTCHA code, click on download Chelan file. Now the CSI file downloaded. After downloaded the CSI file, go to the RPU utility. On any tab, click on create file. Now it is asking the CSI file. Upload the CSI file here. Error or upload and a statistics report file path. Here select the path for generating the report. Any file folder you can select for generating the report. Now the validate button activated. Click on validate. File validated successfully at so and so path. Click on OK. Again click on OK. Now the FUV file created, text file created, 27A also created. So you can use this FUV file for filing the TDS return. No need to go to the TIN facilitation centers. From our office itself, you can file the TDS return online. I have already uploaded a video how to e-file TDS return online. You just go through it. You can do it from your office itself. So we have to zip this RPU. After zipped the RPU, we have to digitally sign the utility. For digitally signing the utility, the DSC management utility available. By using the DSC utility, we have to digitally sign it. After digitally signed the documents, go to the income tax department, incometaxgov.in, the new portal. Instead of using the PAN, we have to use the TAN number as the user ID. So for using the TAN number for the user ID, we have to register the TAN to the income tax portal. That I will upload a video how to register TAN number to the income tax portal. After registering the TAN to the income tax portal, then only we can e-file the TDS return online. So to the income tax portal, we can log in two ways, either by using the PAN number or by using the TAN number. If you are logging with the PAN number as the user ID, we can file income tax returns and some other services. But if you are logging with the TAN number, then only we can file TDS return online. Then only we can file the 15G or 15H online. I will upload another video how to register the TAN number to the income tax portal. Now the new income tax portal not working properly. Otherwise, I will upload a video. Wait for a few weeks. I will upload a new video. So this is the pro version of the TDS Excel utility. This is developed for the professionals. If you want the utility, you can drop your comments along with your email ID, I will contact you. This utility is very much useful for the professionals and the directors who have multiple companies. No need to keep the data in a paper form. No need to worry on the last minute. Everything we can do simply. Here on the RPU, if you want to file another client, just select that client name. Here I am selecting one client name. Only two channels under three sections. Select another client. This have 12 directories with around 9 channels. One more client, 19 directories, around 12 channels. So in a simple way, we can generate the data and we can just copy this data from here and paste it to the RPU. Everything is very simple. No need to input everything by hand. Just copy and select it. The only thing is, when we selected a client, you have to enter the challenge by sections only. So when we selected the client, the concerned directed sections loaded here. Click on each section. The challenge of that section will load here. Click on another section. 194H have 8 directives with 5 challenge. So after selecting the section, select the challenge. Input the challenge to the RPU on the challenge tab and the directive details to the annexer. After completing the first challenge, go to the next challenge, create the challenge, assign the directives, go to next challenge, insert the challenge, then assign the directives likewise. So you can simply copy the data from our utility to the RPU. If you really like the utility, please drop your comments, mention your email ID, mention your requirements. I will share this utility with you, especially the professionals. You can share this utility to your clients. They will fill the database as and when they detected TDS. They fill the challenge details here. Then you can call this utility from your clients. You can migrate the data to the master utility. If you really like the video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. You will get real-time notifications when I uploaded this type of very, very useful utilities. We can meet on next video. Till then, bye.